Let me read a letter I recently received. Dear Dr. Green, why seem fit to suppress our reproductive cycle? Sincerely, a concerned citizen. Thank you for writing, concerned. Of course, your question touches on one of the basic biological interests, with all its associated hopes and fears. I also detect some unspoken questions. Do our benefactors really know what's best for us? What gives them the right to make this kind of decision for men? Will they ever deactivate the suppression field and let us breathe? Allow me to address the anxieties underlying your concern, rather than try to answer every possible question you might have left unanswered. First, let us consider the first time ever. As a species, immortality is in our mind. This simple fact has far-reaching implications. It requires radical rethinking and revision of our genetic imperatives. It also requires planning and forethought that run in direct opposition to our neural presets. I find it helpful at times like these to remind myself that our true enemy is instinct. Instinct was our mother when we were an infant species. Instinct coddled us and kept us safe in those hard-scrabble years when we hardened our sticks and cooked our first meals above a meager fire and started at the shadows that leapt upon the cabin's walls. Instinct is inextricably bound to unreasoning impulses, and today we clearly see its true nature. Instinct has just become aware of its irrelevance, and like a cornered beast, it will not go down without a bloody fight. Instinct would inflict a fatal injury on our species. Instinct creates its own oppressors and bids us rise up against them. Instinct tells us that the unknown is rather than the unknown. Instinct slyly and covertly compels us away from change and progress. Instinct, therefore, must be expunged. It must be fought tooth and nail, beginning with the basis of human urges, the urge to reproduce. We should thank our benefactors for giving us respite from this overpowering force. They have thrown a switch and exercised our demons in a single stroke. They have given us the strength we never could have seen to overcome this compulsion. They have given us purpose. They have turned our we have mastered ourselves, the day we can prove we no longer need. And that day of transformation